How can I include computer sounds in my QuickTime Player screen recordings? Well, I'll show you how, coming up. Hey, it's Mike with more tips and tools to help you create engaging, informative, and educational video. And if it's your first time here, welcome. And make sure you hit that big subscribe button. And don't forget to click the little bell icon so you don't miss a thing. You know, QuickTime Player is a great little media creation tool that comes pre-installed on a Mac. And since version 10.6 of OS X, QuickTime Player has had the ability to do screen recording. Very handy for creating software tutorials or recording slideshow presentations. But QuickTime Player has one big limitation when it comes to screen recording. You see, it can record the screen, voiceover narration, but it can't record computer sounds. Can't record the sounds coming from the applications that you're demonstrating, for example. QuickTime Player just can't do that alone. It can do it, however, if you add an extra piece of software called iShowU Audio Capture. iShowU Audio Capture is a free audio driver made by a company called Shiny White Box. So let's hop onto the computer so I can show you how to use iShowU Audio Capture to record computer sounds for your QuickTime Player screen recordings. So here we are on my Mac. I'm running Mac OS 10.13.2. So the first thing you're going to need to do is download and install iShowU Audio Capture. Now, I'm not going to take up time in this tutorial explaining how to do that. There are detailed instructions for downloading and installing iShowU Audio Capture right here on Shiny White Box's website. You'll find a link to this download and installation page, as well as other helpful information for installing iShowU Audio Capture in the description below this video, so please check that out. So once you have iShowU Audio Capture installed, you're going to have to do a bit of virtual audio wiring on your Mac. There are a few steps involved, but it's not too crazy. Just stay with me and we'll go through it step by step. So the first thing you want to do is open the Audio MIDI Setup application on your Mac. So I'm going to do that by going up to the top menu here and selecting the Spotlight search icon, this magnifying glass icon. And then in the entry field, I'll type MIDI. And the first search result should be Audio MIDI Setup. I'll double-click that to launch it. You can also find the Audio MIDI Setup application in your Applications folder within the Utilities folder. So having a look at the Audio MIDI Setup interface, you can see in the left panel here we have all of the audio devices on our Mac. Here's the internal or built-in microphone, the built-in output, which is usually your speakers or headphones if you have them plugged into your computer. Here's the USB microphone I have plugged in, the Rode NT-USB. And here is iShowU Audio Capture. You can think of iShowU Audio Capture as a virtual device that captures and plays sounds coming from the computer. All right, getting back to the task at hand, we want to be able to record our voice through the microphone, along with the sounds coming from the computer, the application sounds, etc., for our QuickTime Player screen recording. So what we need to do is combine our microphone sound with the computer sound, which is represented by iShowU Audio Capture in this list here. To do that, we're going to go down here and select this little plus icon. And from the drop-down list, we're going to select Create Aggregate Device. Aggregate is just a fancy word for something that's formed by combining many separate components or items. In our case, those separate items are our microphone and iShowU Audio Capture. So with our aggregate device selected, you can see we have some settings on the right side of the panel here. So in the device list down here, in the Use Checkboxes column, you want to select iShowU Audio Capture and your microphone. For clock source, select your microphone. I've found that selecting my microphone as the clock source gave me the best results. And for sample rate, 44.1 kHz is fine. Just make sure all your other sources are using the same sample rate. So, you can select iShowU audio capture and make sure it's using the same sample rate. In our case, that's 44.1 kHz. And do the same for the other audio sources you're using, if possible. So once your aggregate device is set up, you can change its name to something that's more recognizable to you. All you need to do is just select the name and type in a new one right here in this field. And then just hit return to lock it in. So now that our microphone and computer sound are combined into this aggregate device, it'll show up as a single source that we can select in the microphone settings for QuickTime Player. That'll make a whole lot more sense when we start our QuickTime Player screen recording. The next step in our setup is going to allow us to output and listen to the computer sound as we're recording our screencast, which is important. We want to be able to hear that computer sound so that we're not talking over it during our screen recording. So to set that up, we're going to go back down to this little plus icon at the bottom of the audio devices panel and select that. And from the drop-down list, this time, we're going to select Create Multi-Output Device. The multi-output device is like a splitter. It allows us to send different sounds simultaneously to different places. So in our case, we want sound to go to iShowU audio capture, which is our computer sound, so we'll select that. I'm going to select my Rode NT-USB microphone because it has a built-in headphone jack, which allows me to monitor sound through the microphone. So if I select that here, I'll be able to monitor the computer sound as well as my microphone sound through the Rode NT-USB. Now, if your microphone doesn't have a built-in headphone jack, you can select built-in output. This will send the sound to your speakers or your headphones, which are plugged into your Mac. Now, I don't need to select this for my setup because, again, I can hear all the sounds through the headphone jack in my microphone. But I'm going to select it so that you can hear the computer sounds during this tutorial recording. Now, under Master Device, I'm going to again select my microphone. And that's it for the audio MIDI setup. We can close out of that. The last step before we start recording is to switch our sound output to that new multi-output device we just created. So to do that, I'm going to go back up to the top menu here, and under the Apple icon, I'm going to select System Preferences. Then head over and select Sound, and select the Output button, and make sure the multi-output device we just created is selected. So now we'll be able to output and monitor the computer sounds for our QuickTime Player recording. So let's test our setup. I'm going to close out of the Sound panel here. And I've got this iMovie project open that I'm going to use for our demo. It's got a video clip on the timeline that has sound, as you can see from the waveform down here in the audio track. So we're going to listen for this sound in our screen recording to make sure that our setup is working. Okay, let's record. So I'm going to launch QuickTime Player from Spotlight Search. So I'll head up to the top menu bar and select this magnifying glass icon. And I'll type in or start to type in QuickTime Player, and there it is. And I'll double click that to launch it. You can also find QuickTime Player in your applications folder. Now once QuickTime Player is running, I'll go up to the top menu bar, making sure QuickTime Player is active, and select File, New Screen Recording. And I'll get this little screen recording interface. Then I'll select this little down arrow beside the record button to bring up some options. And under microphone, I'll select that aggregate device we created. So my microphone and computer sound will now be recorded at the same time during my QuickTime Player screen recording. Now you may need to adjust your microphone level. It's pretty simple. Just go up to the Apple icon on the top menu bar. We'll select System Preferences. Head over to Sound. And then select the Input button. And select your microphone. Here's my microphone, the Rode NT-USB. And then you can just adjust the input level of your microphone using this slider down here. You'll also notice that iShowU Audio Capture is in the input list. So you can also adjust its level by just selecting it and using the slider here. I'm going to leave mine at 100%. All right, now we're ready to record. I'll just close out of this sound panel here. And in the QuickTime Player interface, I'll hit the record button. I'll get this on-screen prompt. Click to record the full screen, drag to record part of the screen. Now I want to record the full screen, so I'll just click anywhere on the screen here. And we're recording. And I know we're recording because this stop icon way up here on the top menu bar is solid black. All right, let's do a little demo screen recording. So here we are in the iMovie interface, and I have this video clip on the timeline down here. Let's play this video clip. I'll do that by hitting the space bar. So there you have it. Avoid those five big mistakes, and you will be well on your way to creating engaging and effective how-to videos.
Which brings us to the end. All right, I'll stop the clip playing by hitting the space bar again.
Okay, let's stop our little screen recording demo. Now, there are two ways you can stop your screen recording. You can go up to the top menu bar and select that little stop icon again. A less conspicuous way to stop your screen recording is to use the keyboard shortcut Command Control Escape. I'll just select the stop icon since I'm here. Once you stop recording, your recorded file will pop up automatically so that you can check it. So here's our recorded file. I'm just going to resize this so that we can see it a bit better. So let's see what we've got. I'll head down here and select the play button on the QuickTime Player. And I know we're recording because this stop icon way up here on the top menu bar is solid black. All right, let's do a little demo screen recording. So here we are in the iMovie interface, and I have this video clip on the timeline down here. Let's play this video clip. I'll do that by hitting the space bar.
So there you have it. Avoid those five big mistakes, and you will be well on your way to creating engaging and effective how-to videos.
All right, I'll stop the clip playing by hitting the space bar again. Okay, let's stop our little screen recording demo. I'll just stop that. So in our final recording, we have our voiceover narration from our microphone and the sounds coming from the computer. In this case, that video clip on the iMovie timeline. Now, if you're done doing your screen recording, you may want to switch your audio output from the multi-output device back to the speakers or the headphones. A shortcut for that is to just go up to the speaker icon on the top menu bar. Select it, and you'll get this drop-down list of sound output sources on your Mac. So you can just select your built-in sound output, be it your speakers or headphones, from here. And finally, if you're happy with your screen recording, you can save it by going up to the top menu and making sure QuickTime Player is active, and selecting File, Save, and then find a spot on your machine to save your recording.
So with a little bit of fiddling, you can turn QuickTime Player into a free, easy-to-use screen recording application for your Mac. Now, it's not going to replace dedicated, full-featured screen recording applications like ScreenFlow or Camtasia. But if you're looking for a quick solution to record your Mac computer screen, it'll do the trick. Well, that's it for this video. I hope you found value in it. And if you want to discover more tips and tools for creating engaging, informative, and educational video, please hit that big subscribe button so you don't miss a thing. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.